For the first time in history, an all-girls team from Sacramento won the Marine Technology Society Underwater Robotics Competition. This morning, we have all the members of that team from St. Francis High School joining us to talk about this accomplishment. Congratulations, young ladies. That's pretty cool. So why don't we start off with Nora? Why don't you tell us a little bit about what is this competition all about, and what did it take to go ahead and put together your underwater submersible?
So we compete in what's called the May ROV competition, or Marine Advanced Technology and Education. And then ROV stands for Remotely Operated Vehicle. Mm-hmm. And essentially what we do for the competition is we design and then we build this ROV that is capable of completing all the tasks that are given to us at the beginning of the year. And so we start around August, the beginning of our school year, and then we build the ROV up until January, and then we start putting it in the pool for testing and just running mission tasks.
Oh my gosh, okay, so this is a very cool machine. I wish we had like a big tub or something, we could just dip it on in. But again, you folks ended up winning this global competition. Lauren, what does it mean to be the first to win this competition?
I think it's really important to be a role model to all the young girls out there that also want to be in STEM. I know when I was younger, I really looked up to my role models, and we still look up to our role models, and I feel honored to be that role model for someone else and to show that women can be in STEM and that we can do it really, really well.
How exciting was it when you guys, when it was announced that you folks won?
I think it was surreal.
It was really surreal. Yeah. I was like, I couldn't believe it.
Yeah, we've only been a team for about 3 years, and so getting first place that fast was so crazy.
Okay, so we see some video here, and there you all are, poolside. What is happening right now during this competition? What is the goal here?
So, like I said, at the beginning of the year, we get a bunch of tasks and missions that we do, and you can see a lot of them in the water right now.
Yeah.
But at competition, we have a 15-minute mission run where we have the opportunity to attempt as many of these tasks as possible using our ROV.
What are some of those tasks?
One of them would be maybe identifying fish and then acclimating them in the correct climate.
Okay. All right. Yeah, you can see it moving along. And so, as far as you're concerned, everything went off without a hitch?
Well,
maybe not perfect.
Maybe not perfectly. Maybe not what we expected, but we definitely did do well.
Awesome. Okay, Lauren, you touched on the idea of being role models and St. Francis in all-girls school. So what does that mean to be in an environment like that, to not just be in that type of environment, but to also be able to win an accomplishment like this?
Me personally, I really like the all-girls aspect because we get to, I think it helps us boost our creativity, and I know I'm personally less scared to fail in an all-girls environment, and I am more willing to put my ideas, even if I'm not sure if they'll work, and just make mistakes. And I think that's how we really learn, and I think that's a really important part of our team, and it's just a really welcoming environment. And you don't have to know much about robotics, you just have to be committed and interested in learning it, and then you can do great things.
I gotta imagine too, there's been so much talk in the news about just submersibles. Did this start piquing your interest even more into just underwater safety and exploration?
Well, a lot of our safety protocols that we have in place have been there just for our own team member safety, and just because we like to have a safety culture at our robotics, just because we're working with machinery and we're working with like moving thrusters. And so we gotta be careful with what we can like tie our hair back, putting on safety, like hard hats. And so that was something that we had in place before, but obviously the Titan submersible has brought that more to the attention of just everyone else. And we've gotten some questions about like, do you think the ROVs will go forward in the future to maybe replace and make it more safe for ocean exploration and research? And we definitely think so.
Hey, who knows? Maybe you'll help develop the very next one. Hey, congratulations again to St. Francis, and thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.